Hello, this is Dr. Arundhati Hoskeri, an educationist by profession and an astrologer by passion. Today, I will be talking something about mantra. So what do we exactly mean by mantra and how they can be helpful to us? Mantra literally means self-advice. Mantra is defined in Sanskrit as Mananat Trayate Iti Mantraha. What do we mean by this? Manana means manan karna. Manan is a repetition. Trayate means seeking protection or that which protects. So, mantra means repetition of a particular word or group of words to overcome difficulties and to seek and get protection from Almighty God. It is interesting to note that the word mantri or advisor or a minister is derived from mool word, root word mantra in Sanskrit. Thus, mantra is a sacred utterance having strong religious or spiritual quality. It indicates the presence of divinity. Mantra may be a syllable like Om, only one syllable there, a word or phonemes or group of words in Sanskrit basically. But from time to time, actually scholars and saints have translated mantras into regional languages also so that common people could recite. Originally, the mantras come from Rig Veda, so they are all in Sanskrit in Hinduism. Every thought and every word we utter has vibration. These vibrations influence and enhance our psychological as well as spiritual powers. Chanting mantras correctly with proper, concentration can heal the physical and psychological ailments. And this has been, experimented by so many enthusiasts and it has really worked. And I have recommended so many mantras to different people and they have really found good results with that. But there is a word of caution here. Chanting them wrongly can have adverse effects. If you are not familiar with Sanskrit pronunciation, then it is better to listen to mantras with concentration and get desirable results. And, but you need to be also careful while selecting the mantras. There are some kind of very powerful Bija mantras or Vedic mantras. And you cannot chant them everywhere and anywhere. And, there are a lot of rules and restrictions to be followed or else they will have adverse effects on you. So there are so many, simple mantras. Say like Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya or Krishnam Mama Sharanam Raja or Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha or Om Namah Shivaya or even Sarva Mangala Mangale Shive Sarvartha Sadike Charanne Trayambike Devi Narayani Namostute. So these kind of simple mantras can be chanted by everybody and there are not many restrictions. But be very, very careful when you chant Bija mantras and all that and take care and try to explore this world of mantras. Actually, basically see what happens is this is something like a mind and sound resonation in our body. Every word we utter has vibrations which affect our entire body and our psychological well-being. And every thought we create, what is thought? Thought is nothing but internal dialogue with our own selves. We are constantly talking to ourselves. Whatever happens in our head is a self-conversation. So when you talk with others, it becomes a dialogue, Otherwise, the monologue is going on and on and on silently in your head. So every thought, that is the reason, every thought, every word you produce has effect on your body. That is the reason why our elders always told us chant the mantras and all this is coming from Vedic wisdom. It is not that anybody has written anything. It's not a fancy poetry that we are chanting. The mantras are not, fancy poetry or anybody's imagination. Our Rishi Muni and all those people were so very, they had such a power of mind. See, in those days, there was no Google and there was nothing there was no Wikipedia to read and gather information. All this wisdom, Vedic wisdom was explored only using their mind power. So So mind is the most powerful thing. It is the best computer which is devised by God is human being and the human brain. And your mind is the most powerful one. So I hope you enjoyed this information. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. God bless. Shubham Bhavatu.